Today I'm going to show you how to make this lovely tamarind seed bladder bracelet using a silk cord as your framing material. And I'm going to start off by showing you how to use a softer material with silk wraps in your finish. And then after I show you this one, I'll show you how to use a thicker, denser material like this Korean wax cotton. The same technique will also work with Japanese wax cotton, Irish flaxed linen, or leather. So starting with the softer material, you'll need one length of your framing material, and when it's folded in half, it needs to be at least the length that you'll want it to be, and then you'll want an extra 4 to 5 inches on top of it for this braided closure part. And then if you want a longer bracelet, you'll want to add on whatever that length is. So for this one, if I want a 7 1/4 inch bracelet, I'll need at least 12 1/4 to 13 inches, and then if I want it to wrap around again, I'll add another 7 1/4 to that. And then depending on how many times you want it to wrap will be how long your cord will have to be. These come in fixed lengths, so you can only do these in a doubled bracelet maximum. So I'm using this from our bougainvillea mix. All these materials are for sale at beadshop.com, and these mixes are really great because you get a variety of colors. So, you know, you can go to your bead stash and you might end up pairing colors that you wouldn't necessarily think to pair off the top of your head because you have them on you and you can see how they're going to look. So I chose our wine flavor of that cord. And then on top of that, you will need a button for your closure. You'll need a spool of super long size 18. The size of your thread, of your beading thread, may vary depending on the sizes of the holes in your beads. Your limiting factor is that it must pass through the hole of your bead twice. So if it doesn't do that, you'll want to test it before you start making your bracelet. Just take off a sample piece and make sure that two tails can fit in. And if they don't, you'll want to size down. And then on top of that, you'll want your beads. I'm going to use our tamarind seeds. 3 millimeter gold fill rounds and 3 millimeter silver rounds. I'm going to mix my metals. And then you'll also want a scrap piece of rat tail or twine, anything that's thick and can hold a knot. It'll need to be under some tension, so don't choose something too flimsy like cotton for sewing. And then you'll also want a binder clip. A tape measure. And wire cutters. You're going to take your cord and you're going to start with whichever clasp you want. So you'll want this picked out in advance. So I'm just going to put this directly on the cord, fold it in half so it makes a U. And then I'm taking a long length of the Super Long 18, and this is 2 yards long, so when it's folded in half, you'll have 2 1-yard length tails to work with. And then you're just going to do the same thing with that. String it into the button. And pull it down so that both tails are equal length. And they're going to obviously be longer than your framing tail, and you want it to be so. And the length of this will vary. If your beads have tiny holes, you'll want to use a smaller stringing material like Super Long Size D. I'm going to do a silk wrap right below the button to keep the button in place. And we have a YouTube video on silk wrapping that you should watch if you don't know how to do a silk wrap. It's very thorough and you'll have a good understanding of how to do it. Okay, so now this is when your scrap piece of cord comes in. And I'm using a piece of rat tail, but you can use twine, something substantial. You don't want to use anything that's going to break under decent tension. And so I'm going to take one end and cut it at a taper, and then I'm going to use this to strap it down to the design board so that it's easier, it holds your frame tautly, and it makes it easier to do the actual wrapping. So, same concept as before, you're going to feed it through, bring it to you so that the tails are even, and then you're going to take the tails of your framing cord. Get these ones out of the way. And then you're going to just tie an overhand knot at the end, like this. So you'll need some cord in addition to however long you think you'll want to make your bracelet. So I'm going to take this, and I'm going to flip my design board around and bring this cord into the back. So they're meeting right here. And you're going to take one tail of your rat tail and bring it through so the knot is stopping it. You fed it through the legs. And then you're going to tie a square knot. So do right over left. Hold it down with your pinky to keep it tautly in place, and then left over right. It can have some, it doesn't have to be super tight. You don't have to be able to pluck it like a guitar, but you want it to hold this frame in place pretty well. So now you have that, and then these two tails need to be free. Do not strap those down. And then you'll want to bring both of them up through the center of those two tails. And then before you put your first bead on, you're going to start your wrapping process. And you can wrap either around this way, or you can go the reverse and bring it around and in. Whichever way you choose, there's no right way. You just want to make sure that you're doing it consistently in the same way each time. So I'm going to go through the center and around the sides. Bring the tails up and through completely. And then I'm going to do the same thing again. Now, if you skip this step and don't do this, the first bead that you put on is going to be able to pop out of place. So this will lock it in position and keep it from moving around. Okay, so now that I have my tails wrapped around twice, I'm going to take my ends and I'm going to cut them at an angle to make the beading part of this a little bit easier. And you can take some hypo cement or some clear nail polish and paint your tails with it. Let them dry, and then it'll make needles to make beading a little bit easier. So you're going to take your beads and string them on either side. I'm going to start with the left, but you can start on the right if you are so inclined. I'm going to put a gold fill bead on, a wood bead on, and then another gold fill bead, and then with the other tail you're going to come in the opposite direction and you're going to go through each bead again. So I'm going to bring it over . Keep it on both strings so that they're crossed. And you're going to bring it through the wood, then through the other gold fill round. And sometimes it takes some patience. Okay, so now you'll have your beads with both strings coming out, and you're just going to pull both strings until they cinch up into the middle. And you will not get them flush with the end, so don't try. You're going to have a little triangle. And the wider your beads are, the bigger this little triangular space is going to be, so do keep that in mind. So now those are in there tautly, and you're going to repeat the same steps as before. You're going to bring your tails. I'm going up and through in the same direction I did before. Just keep your direction the same. And I bring it around once, and then once more. So I do it twice. You can do it once, but I like doing it twice because especially with the softer framing material, it gives it a tighter look in the end. I do have a sample I'll show you in the end, showing you what it looks like with one. And then I'm going to pattern the gold and silver beads. So I'm going to go three of these with gold, four with silver, three with gold, do whatever you want. So again, on the left side, I'm going to put my gold fill bead on, followed by a wood bead, followed by a gold bead, string it down, I'm going to take my other tail, go back through in the opposite direction, come back through the gold beads, and then back through the wood, and then your other gold beads. Pull the top, and then repeat your steps until you have your desired length. And for this style, you'll want to bead all the way down, and then you'll want to leave about half an inch of room for your loop that you're going to fashion in the end.